Hi, I'm Brooke.
I'm Harlow.
And today we're here as part of the Melton Lifelong Learning Festival, teaching you guys how to cook our three most favourite salads. So today we're going to be making one of our favourite salads. This is a coleslaw. We love it because it's quick, it's easy, and it's super healthy. There's no cooking involved, and we're using fresh ingredients or fresh seasonal produce. So this is a really, really simple salad. It's simply combining all the ingredients. So there's no reason to go to the shop and buy the store-bought coleslaw anymore. First, we're going to place the green cabbage into the bowl, and we're just gonna kind of loosen it up a little bit. Then we're gonna grab our red cabbage and we're gonna combine that. We're gonna mix those two cabbages through, and you're gonna see this beautiful color. The green cabbage is gonna make the purple cabbage stand out. And we're gonna continue to combine that. And now we're gonna add some grated carrot. And we're gonna put that in. You're gonna look at all these beautiful colors coming through now. And we're gonna keep combining that with our fingers. If you don't wanna use your fingers, you can always use a big giant spoon, but I feel that this combines the ingredients a lot better. And as you can see, that's looking wonderful, but wait till we add the green celery. Now we put that through and we just keep mixing it and mixing and mixing. And the red capsicum, we pop that through. Now we really have the colours of the rainbow in here, don't we? So now all of those ingredients have combined beautifully in the bowl, it's time to add the lemon. So we're gonna get Harlow to squeeze the juice of half of a lemon into the bowl, making sure her fingers are close together so that none of those pips fall through into the coleslaw. And my secret ingredient is mustard. So we're adding a teaspoon of Dijon mustard and we're going to combine that through, making sure that it's mixed through thoroughly with the lemon before we add the mayonnaise. So it really depends on how much mayonnaise you like. I like a lot of mayonnaise in my coleslaw. So as I say to the kids, I always start with one tablespoon and I'll mix that through. Then I'll add another one because you can't take it back if you've added too much. It's always easier to add more. So I'm going to start with one tablespoon and I'm going to add that through and I'm going to combine all these ingredients. You can see now that looks amazing. And I need another tablespoon, so I'm adding another tablespoon of mayonnaise. And I can see that that's looking really creamy now, but not creamy enough for me. So I'm gonna add one more and I'm gonna continue to mix it through. Now you can see that looks amazing. Look at the color in there. And that's it. That is your simple salad. That is your simple coleslaw. You can put it in have a barbecue. You could put it in a sandwich. What else do we have coleslaw in?
We have it with steak.
Yeah, we have it with steak. Why do you like coleslaw?
Because it tastes yum.
And now we're going to make our next salad, which is Harlow's brother's favourite. What salad does Ryder like the most?
Mango salsa.
That's right. Now, we love mango salsa. It doesn't last very long in our house. It gets gobbled up very, very quickly. But when we do have it, we serve it with chicken thighs or chicken breasts. So let's get started. So first, I'm going to add two diced mangoes to the bowl. I'm gonna pop them in and then add one diced red capsicum. I'm just gonna mix them through very gently because the mango is quite delicate. I'm just gonna turn that over. And then I'm gonna add some red onion. I'm not gonna add too much because it will turn the kids off. It's quite a strong flavor, so just a little bit in there. Now, the second last ingredient, everybody loves to hate it, is coriander. I think this steals the show and makes the dish. It is one of my favorite herbs. So we're just gonna add a sprinkle of that through and mix that through. And now to finish it off, I'm just gonna get Harlow to juice one lime for us. So there you have it, guys. That is our very quick, simple, healthy, and vibrant mango salsa. So this next salad we're gonna cook for you today is Harlow's favorite. Would you like to tell everybody what it is?
Potato salad.
That's right. This is what we call grandma's potato salad. So my grandma made this recipe after Harlow was diagnosed as having allergies to eggs. And so we couldn't have the traditional potato salad that we used to have with boiled eggs in it and mayonnaise. So I've pre-cooked 1 kilo of Dutch cream potatoes and I've just cut them up into 1 centimeter pieces. I've got some green beans here, which Harlow has very kindly topped and tailed for me and cut in half. And we're just gonna pop them into some boiling water and blanch them for about 2 or 3 minutes. So while the beans are blanching, we're quickly gonna fry off 2 rashers of bacon, which I've gently diced, and also half half a white onion. So I'm just gonna fry them off for about 2 or 3 minutes. They smell amazing. And we'll just continue to cook them until they're a little bit crispy. That just gives us a little different texture throughout the salad. It smells so good. So now that the bacon and onion are cooked, it's time for the final step, and that's to make our dressing. So the dressing is quite simple. We are literally just throwing everything together in a jug and mixing it up. So today I've got 4 spring onions. I've just cut the white parts of them. We have 1 tablespoon of fresh parsley out of the vegetable garden and 1 tablespoon of fresh mint. The mint just makes this salad. And then over here we've also got some dried basil, some dried tarragon, dried mustard powder, and 1 clove of garlic. If garlic isn't available, also you can also use fermented garlic paste, which is what we're using today. So now I'm going to combine all of those ingredients with 1/4 cup of olive oil, 1.5 teaspoons of brown vinegar, and 2 tablespoons of beef stock. So now I've got all those ingredients in the jug, I'm gonna get Harlow to mix it up for me. So now that Harlow's mixed up that dressing for us, I'm going to place the cooked bacon, the onion, and the beans in with the potatoes, and we're gently gonna mix that through. Just very gently, because the potatoes are quite delicate. We'll just mix it through, and then Harlow's gonna pour the dressing over the top for us as I continue to mix. So there you have it. Here's Harlow's favorite egg-free potato salad. Thanks for joining us today. We hope you enjoyed our recipes. You can find them on our website, theorganicplace.com.au, to enjoy with your family as well.